Здравейте, колеги! В днешния ден, втория от провеждане на неформалния съвет по правосъдие и вътрешни работи, ще обсъдим с колегите министри на правосъдието няколко теми. Преди всичко искам да споделя, че от ключово значение за българското председателство в сферата на правосъдието е осигуряване на бързо, ефективно и справедливо правосъдие, основано на взаимното доверие между съдебните системи на различните държави членки, спазвайки принципа на върховенството на правото. Първата тема, която ще бъде предмет на дебат на министрите, е свързана с институционализиране и изграждането на службата на Европейския прокурор. Днес очаквам мнение във връзка с начина, по който службата на Европейския прокурор ще си взаимодейства с останалите служби на Европейския съюз, като Евроюс, Интерпол, ОЛАФ. Втората тема е свързана с така наречения регламент Брюксел 2А, един законодателен акт, който цели бързина и ефективност при връщане на дете, отвлечено от родител, както и зачитане и изпълнение на съдебно решение от една държава спрямо родителски права в друга държава. По време на работния обяд ще обсъдим и за възможността да се използват постиженията на роботиката и изкуствения интелект за облекчаване достъпа до правосъдие, за постигане на по-голяма ефективност и бързина, както и ще обсъдим някои етични норми във връзка с използването на тези съвременни модерни технологии, които аз съм убедена ще служат и в полза на по-доброто правосъдие за напред.
Госпожо Цачева, какво мислите Вие за предложението да се обвърже системата на правото с фондовете на Европейския съюз?
Не бива да се счита, че това е някакъв вид санкция. Както комисар Юрова, комисаря по правосъдие, защита на правата и потребителските права, сподели, така или иначе всички държави членки спазваме член 2 от договора за Европейския съюз, където върховенството на правото, зачитането на човешките права и свободи е задължение на всяка една от държавите. В този смисъл аз очаквам с интерес какво ще бъде последващото развитие по тази тема от страна на Еврокомисията.
Сейчас мы что-то заказываем. I'm sure Bulgaria is going to make a great presidency. No doubt about that. I think as under the Estonian presidency, we get the result to establish EPPO. So I'm sure all the preparatory work, which is a huge amount of work, will be solved under the Bulgarian presidency. And very important is a cooperation level between the EPPO, Eurojust and OLAF. And I'm sure the right balance will be found and the platform for that is going to happen here in Sofia. So.
Thank you. Wie man so lange Aufnahmeverkehr geht dann?
Nein, nicht so lange wie.
Also die Vergärbung, die schlafen wir jetzt schon.
Ja, ja,
10 das Uhr. Ich sagte, war jemand da, sagt, der hat sich gehindert daran.
Ja, haben wir mal geschaut, wo der Minister schläft.
Aber wir haben geschaut, ob das wohl keine nötige oder so was ist, muss ich gleich sagen.
Der Minister.
Also, soll man sagen, ja.
Wir müssen jetzt hier sein. Bleibst du?
Wunderbar. Er steht.
Herr Minister, mit welchen Erwartungen kommen Sie heute her? Erster Auftritt auf EU-Ebene.
Es geht darum, dass man tatsächlich auch auf EU-Ebene, wie gesagt, die weiteren Beziehungen eben pflegt und gleichzeitig auch jene Maßnahmen in Gang setzt, um eben Sicherheit in Europa zu forcieren.
Sie sind in Österreich bekannt dafür, dass Sie aufräumen wollen mit ganz vielen Regeln. Welche EU-Regeln könnte man dann streichen?
Streichen ist es sicherlich so, dass also die Subsidiarität ausgebaut werden soll. Das heißt, also hat die Juncker darauf hingewiesen, dass weniger, aber das effizienter gemacht werden sollte. Und in diese Richtung werden auch unsere Bemühungen gehen.
Fällt Ihnen da irgendwas Konkretes ein?
Es gibt sehr viele Regulierungen, das heißt in Österreich gehen wir nicht.
Dobre utro, Portaria.
As always, I expect a very good discussion with the colleagues, the Ministers of Justice. The European Public Prosecutor's Office is a very important body which will function from 2020 and will deal with the fraud and corruption on structural funds and other kinds of European money. So it's a very important body for all the European taxpayers. And I'm happy that Bulgaria is one of the establishing countries, because it will increase also the level these kind of criminal offenses are investigated in Bulgaria. I hope so. Rule of law is one of the basic principles we have in the EU, so of course it's important that we discuss about it, that we over the process of this discussion make better understanding of it means to have rule of law in the country, and it will be continuous discussion also over the Austrian presidency later, because we need to focus more on this. Well, to some extent, we discuss it every time. We discuss our matters with the ministers of justice, and I think that we will discuss also, or I'm sure we will discuss also about the rule of law in online sphere, because I want to present how we see the way forward in relation to online hate speech and the illegal content online. Of course, we are following closely what's happening in Romania, because we saw very good progress in the recent years. The reforms were well ongoing, but we always said that we want to see the reforms which will bring higher independence of judiciary and efficiency, to increase also trust of people in the system. And what we see in Romania now could be some worrying signals that the things do not go in the right direction. That's why we engaged in the dialogue with the Romanian government, and that's why we are sending the letter to the government, and we want to start a dialogue from the very beginning of these worrying things.
What does Bulgaria should do to convince the European Commission that
We would like to see Bulgarian justice system to be more efficient in combating corruption and organized crime. So this is always the same thing, that we want functioning system, well placed within the whole system of Bulgarian constitutional setup, and I think that it was very clearly described in our monitoring report from January or from the last year, when we wanted to see tangible results in Bulgarian reforms.
Yeah, but if you're bonding the EU regulations and the finance from the European Union, basically Bulgaria can't give you the money.
Can you repeat? I didn't hear you.
The EU regulations in the report, and if you say we have to just get to comply and we have to get another regulations and money from the European Union,
it's not like this, and I will repeat it again and again. Already now, all the EU funding is connected with rule of law and functioning judiciary in the country. It's already now. We only want to make this clearer for the next financial perspective, that it matters, and maybe to stop setting different more or less technical or marginal conditionalities, and to say this matters, this is very important, so that all the member states are fully aware of that. And it has never been meant only to set such conditions for cohesion countries. We plan to do this for all EU funding horizontally, so I will always repeat that this is not the conditionality for EU funds going to countries like Bulgaria. Thank you. It's real winter here. Yeah. Go inside, please.
Thank you. Denmark, and it please.
Okay.
And then you have the floor. So you never address the last name.
Okay.
So I just tried the first name.
Литво. Швеция.
Good morning.
all of.
Is this the minister?
Yes, the minister.
I'm sorry. I'm not a tourist. How are you? One second, please. In order to be nice for the lady.
What do you expect from today's meeting and why is so important the European Prosecutor's Office? Is it important?
Well, I expect a good and fruitful discussion about the topics and especially about the topic on robotics and electronic commerce, which I believe is very important. Thank you.
Good morning.
The minister said.
More than any other, yeah. I was pleasantly surprised to see an Asselborn. I don't believe there can be a meeting of ministers in any European capital without John.
Good morning. Grazie.
Като ескимос с тази качулк.
Thank you.
веднъж добър ден на всички. Добре дошли в София на неформалната министерска среща правосъдие и вътрешни работи. За мен в качеството ми на министър на правосъдието е особена чест да председателствам днешното заседание –